Welcome to another episode of Is It Really True? My name is Kal Korff and I'm your host. Folks, the purpose of the show is really simple. What we do is we examine various claims and we tell you whether or not they are true. We also provide you with enough facts so that you can independently check the data yourself if you wish to do so. Since we cover everything from politics to the paranormal, that's a wide variety of subjects. Our purpose, once again, is to tell you whether it is really true. Now, today's show is about astrology. Every year, millions of people around the world pay attention to their horoscopes. They depend on what the stars and the planets tell them and various soothsayers known as astrologers who guide their life. Newspapers are full of horoscopes, and in every city, and especially online on the internet, there are countless numbers of self-proclaimed astrologers who will tell you things about yourself based on the readings of the cosmos, and what supposedly is good for you, what's bad for you, what to eat, what not to eat. The amount and number of permutations of astrology are literally endless. The reason this is true is because none of it is credible. None of it is based on science, and none of it is really true. In this two-part series, and we may do a third, a fourth, and a fifth part, depending on how this unfolds, we're going to disprove astrology finally and once and forever. We're going to use basic science, reasoning. We're also going to tell you how you can check the accuracy of astrology yourself, and you'll learn that it is not really true. So if it's not true, it's false. There are stronger words that one can use to describe what is really BS, but that is astrology. Now, astrology is big business around the world. It is especially popular in superstitious-laden countries like India. India, because of its very large population, second in the world only to that of China, India has, unfortunately, a dubious distinction of being the most superstitious country on the planet. There are hundreds of millions of Indians every year, and it's not just Indians, again, it's people around the world. They number in the hundreds of millions total who actually believe in astrology. And there's different kinds of astrology. But let's take a look at some basic premises that guide astrology or what its foundation is. And let's easily destroy them and expose them as being less than credible. The art of astrology, since it is not a science, it never has been, dates back thousands of years. It goes back to the time of the Egyptians, the Mesopotamians, who don't even exist anymore, the Greeks, the Romans, you name it, many civilizations over the millennia have used astrology. Astrology, ironically, did produce something positive. It is one of the basis of what later became astronomy. The key difference, however, between astronomy and astrology is that astronomy is grounded in science and reality, whereas astrology never was. In today's world of astrology, the average astrologer will tell you that there's 12 constellations. That should be your first warning sign that this person is not either educated or telling you the truth where it concerns real science. The fact is, there are at least 88 known constellations, not 12. In fact, there never has been 12, period. It has never existed. In fact, when the number 12 was decided to be the number, the actual number of constellations found at the time were 13. There is one constellation called Ophiuchus, which is ignored because the number 13 is considered bad luck, and 12 is an even number that can be divided into two, whereas 13 cannot. Each constellation is supposed to represent 30 degrees of the equator, never mind the fact that the constellations in reality are of different sizes, and it takes the sun everywhere from 4 to 22 days to pass through them, or for our orbits to be complete, so that they're visible within 4 to 22 day cycles as they pass through each constellation, for lack of a better term. Now, one of the reasons that astrology cannot be true is because when it was invented, literally invented, not discovered, but invented as in made up, thousands of years ago, the constellations back then were very different than they are today. So if you were born in the year 1000 BC or even in the year zero, the sign that you are under supposedly today would very likely be different than it was thousands of years ago. The sign that all of this stuff was originally calculated in thousands of years ago has now changed. In fact, NASA has recently updated a star catalog, kind of just for kicks and a scientific exercise, to show astrologers what nonsense they spew. They have updated the 12 zodiac signs to reflect the current positions in the sky. And guess what happens, folks? Reality. The fact is that the sign that you were supposedly born under as determined thousands of years ago is very likely not going to be the sign that exists today because the stars have shifted over thousands of years. If you don't believe me, try this simple experiment. Simply download on your computer or your smartphone. You can do this from the Apple App Store or the Google Play Store. You can also do this on a Windows or a Macintosh computer. Go ahead and download any number of different astronomy programs where you can actually punch in the dates and years of what you want to look at to see how the sky was at that particular period in time. Take the present day, then choose, say, 100 years ago, 1,000 years ago, 1,500 years ago, 2,000 years ago, and this software will go ahead and show you how the stars have changed over those periods of time. Then try to reconcile this difference with your current sign versus one that the astrologers use today when they do your so-called astronomical chart. Go ahead and see what the difference is between the data that they're using, which is thousands of years old, versus the real data today, which you can easily get online from NASA. You will see that more likely than not, depending on when you were born, because each constellation is of different sizes, you will see that your sign has changed. And if your sign has changed, then you're not what your astrologer has told you, which means he's wrong. And if you can be a Scorpio one minute and then a Sagittarius the next, just to make up two examples, then this disproves that astrology is really true. Another experiment that you can do, which is quite easy, and we will show this in part two of Is It Really True?, where we expose the fraud of astrology. Try this simple experiment. Take any newspaper that runs an astrology column every day. Go ahead and collect the issues for 1 month, or at least 12 days, and go ahead and cut out all of the individual entries for every month of what the horoscope prediction is for that day. Go ahead and make sure that after you've cut out these pieces, that you put them all in different envelopes and randomly mix them up. This way you've got all of the different horoscopes mixed in, and then go ahead and give them out to people and tell them that this is your horoscope for the day. When you do this simple experiment, you will see, and we will prove this in episode two of Is It Really True? Because we will take you through this experiment and actually do it in front of a bunch of people. You will see, and we're mentioning this ahead of time in episode one here, so that we either have incredible psychic powers or we're telling you the truth. And since we're not psychic, I guarantee you we're telling you the truth. What you will find out is when you randomly mix up these horoscope predictions and proclamations, which are supposedly based on what the stars and planets tell you, which again is nonsense, you will see that most people agree with them. Most people agree with them because most people want to believe, or they're sufficiently vague enough so that when a astrologer tells you today's your lucky day, well, who's going to say, actually, no, it's not, I'm going to be unlucky today? You see, this comes back to a phenomenon called the will to believe, and it is inherent in human nature. In fact, in today's world of Twitter, Facebook, and instant so-called news, one has to really pay careful attention, put a very critically minded filter on information, because it's just too easy to deceive people and try to go ahead and convince them that something is true when it's not. We have already exposed false claims on the internet, a very small portion of them, in previous episodes of Is It Really True? So getting back to astrology, again, all you do is a simple experiment, and we will show you this experiment done in front of people in part two of this expose of astrology in an upcoming episode of Is It Really True? You simply take the horoscope news clippings from a newspaper, you cut them out, you mix them up at random, and you give them out to people. Now, if someone says they're a Pisces, don't give them the Pisces horoscope. Give them the Sagittarius one or any other symbol except the one they are. Make sure that everyone who gets them gets somebody else's horoscope. And then ask them what they think of this so-called astrological reading or prediction or proclamation. You will find again that most people will say, yeah, that's pretty right on, that this person did a good job. In reality, this was never true. All you did is randomly mix up a bunch of nonsense claims, and people, of course, want to believe, so they do. This, again, is a simple experiment anybody can do. It's been done many times before. The famous magician and exposer of psychic frauds, James Randi, became world famous in part for doing this experiment, and it has been replicated without fail over and over and over, and we will do it again in front of you in an upcoming episode of Is It Really True? Now, I'll leave you with one last thing. The very idea that astrology would be valid is arguably insane. Think about this for a moment. These stars and planets are billions and trillions of miles away. Some are millions of miles away, depending on what planet you're talking about. The very idea that they will determine what kind of day you have, whether you'll win the lottery, whether you'll meet that special person or not. Do you think the moon really cares whether you have a date that night? Do you think Saturn is busy wondering over what you're going to have for dinner? The number of things that people claim that can be determined by astrology is infinite, and it's all a bunch of hooey. In my own personal experience here in India, and I saw this was also true in the United States and Europe, I've lived on three continents now, I can safely tell you, and I can prove it, that every astrologer that I have tested under carefully controlled scientific conditions has failed. They have failed because they're simply not telling you the truth. So is astrology real? The answer is no. Is it really true? The answer is no. And in part two of our exposé of astrology, you will see us do some carefully controlled scientific experiments that disprove astrology, and we'll share some real stories about astrologers who are out there deceiving the people, taking their money, and that is a potentially dangerous combination, especially when you have people depending on the advice of their astrologer as to whether or not they should see a doctor or engage in certain health practices. That's when this fraud that is inherent in astrology becomes not only dangerous, but arguably criminal. Thanks for joining us for another episode of Is It Really True? This is our exposé on astrology, part one. We will be back with another episode, part two, exposing astrology, next week for episode seven of Is It Really True? My name is Kal Korff. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. Take care.